coming. Remember what we all started this for. If you give up now, we won't ever get this chance again. And it would be in great gratitude if you ruled it.
You're true, right, my student. Let's start again.
I've got it. I've had an epiphany.
You have? You figured it out? You know how to bring that back to life?
Yes.
And much, much more.
I'll take your questions.
Is it a virus?
We don't know.
How does it spread? Is it airborne?
It's a possibility.
Go a little bit more to the right. Oh, who are you?
Well, I'm Mr. Law. We're here regarding the severe issue of the, what shall we call it, the rising of the undead. The problem has affected the rest of the world in minor proportion in comparison to France. We believe this to be due to the higher concentration of corpses caused by a war, particularly World War I. We're not sure if they have a motive, but since the rising of the undead, I've studied their motive, and they seem to have no other goal than infecting civilians. We must find a way of containing the virus.
Yes.
The civilians, they have been infected through the bites and the scratches. Then the transformation, it happens very quickly. The infected have become of great concern in the urban areas.
The living, they fear they will soon be outnumbered.
Ero, I do believe that there have been some leads as to why this may have happened, my friend.
Yes, I've done some research on the subject, and I think I understand now how it spread.
The chemical compound, which then seeped into the ground and caused the dead to rise.
Though we still don't understand why the corpses are from World War I.
World War I? That's impossible.
Clearly it's not.
Well, I'm not that much of a World War I specialist, but I know a bit about its effects on America. It became necessary for women to take up the men's work.
When we're given more rights, like the little though, they enrolled in higher education, the war inadvertently helped move the women's equality movement forward, and along with that, the United States grows to be one of the most powerful nations in the world.
Entry into the war unleashed a massive federal spending. When the war began, the U.S. economy was in a recession. And when the U.S. joined the war, an economic boom ensued from Europeans purchasing U.S. goods for the war. The focus on industry and mass production grew significantly during and after the war. But a large economic crisis occurred when America had to be paid back for its war efforts.
And who could forget those horrible weapons?
Copy. Chemix chemical. It must have sank into ground and reacted with the mustard gas. We need to go. Prime Minister will go study the zombies and find a way to end this.
My heart!
Haha, oh Gosta, my patient zero. I'm the perfect overlord to lead this world in submission. And you are the sorry sap that gets to leave the dead. Glorious. So glorious.
I have to give it to Kaimik. He's a smart man. The way he did all this, he's a crazy genius.
This is just crap. How could anybody do this? The world's going to...
Sorry.
I mean, it's true that this is a crappy situation.
Pues no shit, Sherlock.
Crap!
Darn this book. Not only has it brought back the dead, but it's absolutely devastated our crop. I hate this acid rain.
This isn't just weather, my friend. This is acid rain. It comes from an excess nitrogen in the atmosphere caused by global warming. It won't just be some short-term weather change. This could be a global climate change.
But nitrogen helps our crops, right? It goes into the ground and reacts with bacteria and decomposers. It's a cycle, right?
Oh, very much like photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, plants take in the carbon dioxide, breathe out oxygen. For us, oxygen breathing folk, then breathe that in, breathe out carbon dioxide. It's a cycle.
And now the world is gone too.
Crap!
I just don't understand how this could happen.
Figuratively or literally?
I guess literally.
It all has to do with our atmosphere. Kaimik shot something up into the atmosphere and it came down with the rain to raise the dead.
How did he know to shoot it into the air and not just put it into the ground?
Kaimik was smart in how he diffused the chemical. I assume it was deliberate that he shot it into the lower stratosphere. Most of the world's ozone is there. The air is 1,000 times thinner there than at sea level, and because the air pressure decreases as you go up. The thin air made it easier for the gas to diffuse and settle into the stratosphere.
Oh, okay.
The troposphere contains nearly all the weather and pollution on Earth.
Since most weather vapor is up there, the gas must have been more dense than water in order to create rain with the clouds.
Don't even get me started on the gases. The chemical compound came in contact with nearly every gas in the atmosphere before hitting Earth. Because the atmosphere is made up of nitrogen, oxygen, argon, helium, methane, krypton, hydrogen, carbon dioxide. Because of the acid rain, I'm certain that the chemicals reacted with nitrogen primarily.
Can you stop this amateur talk? It's giving me a headache.
Hey, look, Lazan is making a run for it.
I'm a genius. I've done the unthinkable.
Look at me. What a beautiful genius I am. If I had shot the gas any higher into the mesosphere, it would have burned up. Because not even heaters can withstand that. If I had shot it even higher into the thermosphere, which is even hotter, it would have burned up too. Elevation there is from 40 kilometers to 500. You know what? Let's see. Maybe hot, but nothing's hot. Small molecules around 1,000 degrees Celsius, and so far apart that your panics are practically the whole. Ionosphere and exosphere are full of ionized particles, making the atmosphere able to chemically diffuse. There's like 80% nitrogen and 20% oxygen out there. And there's the pods. Pods are on the between almost every layer. These pods are the heat transition and, well, this is a tropopause, this tripause, and the mesopause. I'm born as a man.
Look at
my beautiful creations, but they're all so pitiful compared to my genius. Nothing can stop me now.
Help me!